Okay, ChatGPT, let's get started. So ChatGPT is an AI which has a text interface, so like a chat box where you ask for things and you get back code usually, or an essay or something. Now, because I like to build digital design, of course I got into, let's see how good is at writing VHDL code or very low code. This example is actually VHDL. So I'm not going to do it live. I went through the whole process, which took like 20 minutes and two beers, and it remains on the screen. So I'm just going to very fast through the whole process. So I started by asking, please write in VHDL an entity, okay, ATT, entity named Axis Stream IP with an Axis Stream slave interface. And this is what I got. I got this, right, this code. Now, looks fairly clean, nicely aligned. I asked for a slave interface, and it seems that I got a master interface as well, as a bonus. And I got here some process which is supposed to register the data. Now, as you can see, it doesn't have a clock. So this is not a synchronous process. Of course, my next ask was, please use a clock signal name A clock. An A clock was added in the port list. And this time I got a process which looks more like it's supposed to look like, with a rising edge on A clock, it do this and it does that, right? Okay, and it's registering the data, which he chose to be 31 bits wide, 32 bit wide. So I don't know why, but anyway, I'm okay with that. I can change that. So I kind of got some sort of usable code here. Then I asked, okay, I would like to have a signal here, T ready, to be registered instead of a non-registered signal, T ready, and I got that, right? So it kind of obeyed, and the next process again, he forgot to add the clock, like he has a very short memory. Anyway, of course I ask, okay, please use the A clock rising edge on the second process as well, and I got that correctly. So the first process and the second process, they're both on the rising edge. So far so good. I said, please remove the master interface, and it did remove the master interface. And then I said, please register data on the rising edge, and it did that very, very nicely. And I kept continuing. I'm not going to go to all the steps. Please add T valid as well. please add an output port. And I kind of went step by step. Yeah, and I got here to a point where I asked for a few signals to be registered. And I kind of give here a more complicated statement. I want this when that is high. And it did exactly that. So it's basically this condition here. so I discovered that if you ask too much in one step, you'll get code which is not exactly functional. But if you go for small asks and you keep adding, you build up your block, you get better results. So anyway, skipping towards the end, this is actually the interesting part here. I got here code which I was kind of happy with the code. I said, okay, I think this is good. Let's call it a day. Then I got an idea. You know what? I said, great. Can you please generate a test bench? And the answer was, sure. Here is the test bench for your entity. So it declared all the signals to hook with my, I wouldn't say my because it was his. All the signals to hook with the DUT, instantiated the DUT here, created a clock, all good. Yeah, and here he made some sort of stimuli, which they make sense, but they were not synchronous. They had nothing to do with the clock. They were just waiting for 10 nanoseconds, waiting. So, of course, my next ask was, please update the input on the rising edge of the clock. Of the A clock, and it did exactly that. So he actually put this. I was expecting to be in a process here, but What he did instead, he was like, wait until the rising edge and then changing and then waiting until the rising edge, which is okay. I mean, it's okay. It's working. It's not exactly the cleanest way to do it, but it's working. And I said here, please add a few more transactions because it was a very short test bench so far. And he added here like a second and the second transaction and all this. Now, he actually made here more than one transaction. It's like a... But anyway, and it was even clever to change the stimuli. So here he put 10100 and he put 01010. So it's not the same pattern sent to the block. So I'm happy with this. I'm happy as in it wrote code, it's functional. I simulated. Okay, it has a few mistakes here and there and I corrected. I even found a bug which I corrected very easy. It's a one-liner bug. So conclusion, ChatGPT. The AI can generate pretty good VHDL code, right? Syntactically correct, sometimes logically incorrect, like missing the clock. Or I discovered that it sometimes is making mistake with variable. It doesn't understand fully where the variable they should be declared and they should live inside the process. Somehow there are silly mistakes that probably a graduate will do. But it's useful. It's useful because I can't write code that clean. I can write probably better clock, better code, but not that clean. So this is very, very nice indented and nicely aligned and nicely structured. So yeah, I can take this and bring it to life. Another thing is that he's writing faster than me. I can't type that fast. This is actually all this code. It took something like maybe 10 seconds to be written. I can't write that much code in 10 seconds. So it's fast, it's clean, it's nicely indented, very explicit, I would say. So everything is done very explicit. Not fully functional, but easy to correct. So would I use it? Of course. This is free. This is the free version. I'm using it this and I would use it as much as I can. It's kind of difficult to get a prompt because it's very, very busy. Many people, they jumped on this. But I'm not going to write code, at least at the initial, at the start point. I'm not going to write it myself. I'm just going to start. It sounds like a template code, but it's good. It's fast. It's nice. I love it. And we'll see what are the advantages for the paid version, because there is a paid version which seems to work better and you get access much easier. So this is it. This is the conclusion. I love it. I like it. I hope it evolves. And I'm not sure what are the implications for the society. I'm going to leave this to other people, which they know more. I just talked about code. I'm an engineer. I don't know psychology and I don't know much about society. That's it. Thank you for watching and I shall see you on the next one.